Dear friends, welcome to another video. Today we review this little OLED screen display that we bought from banggood.com a few days ago. The item was very cheap in Banggood site and it came here in Greece very fast, and we have the chance to review it now and drive it using the Arduino platform. So, first of all, this display is very small in size. As you can see, it is only 3x3 centimeters long and wide. Comparing it with an Arduino Pro Mini, you can see how small it really is. Look, here is an Arduino Pro Mini. It's almost the same size in length, and the Arduino Mini is around 2 centimeters wide and 3.5 long. Let's compare it with an Arduino Nano. As you can see, it's almost half the size in length. And lastly, let's compare it with an Arduino Mega. As you can see, the Arduino Mega is really, really bigger. Now, this OLED display has only 4 pins to connect. The first pin is the ground, the second is the VCC, the third pin is named SEL, and the fourth SDA. Those 2 pins are the only one used in order to communicate with the platform, the processor, the Arduino or any other platform you can use. And those pins uses the I2C protocol. So we need only 4 pins and we are ready to go. First, let's connect this display with the Arduino Mega. The first pin, the ground, is going to be connected, of course, with the ground. So let's connect it. Ground goes to the Arduino ground. The second pin is VCC. So VCC goes to 3.3 volts or 5 volts, whatever you want. It's better to use 3.3 volts. Next is the pin SCL. SCL, the red wire, goes to this pin of the Arduino with the same name. And lastly, the pin SDA goes to SDA in the Arduino Mega. You can use any Arduino you like, of course. So we are ready to power the device on and see how it works. Okay, I plug the USB input and I'm powering from my little power bank. Okay, I press open, and as you can see, our display is powered on and it displays some graphics. Let's zoom in. That flickering is caused by my camera. Okay, now it's better. You can see the display in full action. It displays some graphical elements from the Adafruit GFX library. You can find the library in the link below. Okay, the display is very bright. You can see the display is bright. The colors are bright. The upper one third of the screen is yellow, and the 2/3 below are blue in color. Have that in mind before actually buying one. The price of this device is around 4 euros in banggood.com, and it is the best price that you can find. So it is very easy to use and very nice for small projects. Now, let's see in the computer what do we need in order to light this display up. We are in the computer now and we are going to see how to drive the OLED display. First of all, we have to download the Adafruit GFX library from this link. You can find the link in the description below. All we have to do is to press the download zip here. Then we have to unzip the library to a place. Let's unzip it in the desktop and rename the library. Okay, like this. Next, we have to download the Adafruit SSD 1306 library for the OLED display itself. The other library is for the graphics that it will display. Also, this link is in the description of the video below. We press download zip, unzip it in the desktop as well, and rename it to OLED, for example. We copy or cut those libraries in our Arduino installation in the libraries and paste them here. Okay, we are ready now to open up Arduino. And we go to the examples. As you can see, we have a library here called OLED. We choose this 128x64 I2C example. We load it. And now we have to make a change in this sketch. The only thing we have to change is we go down a little bit and find the initialization line here, this one, display.begin. We have to change those, this 3D to 3C. It is the value that we have to change in order the display from Banggood that you have bought to work. Otherwise, it won't start up. Now, only thing we have to do is to choose our board. I'm using an Arduino Mega, so all I have to do is to press upload. When the compiling is done, it is now uploading, and when the upload is completed, the screen will light up. It is that easy. Using that display, you can make many, many things. You can draw squares, circles, or print some text. It's very easy. But we will make another video about that. Now, let's see our display in action. When upload has finished, we can see something like this. The library that we have uploaded is drawing things in the screen. It can draw lines, squares, circles, anything you can imagine. It can draw bitmaps, and of course it can draw text. That flickering you see in the screen now is invisible with the naked eye. It's probably because of my camera. Now, let's see another interesting thing. Okay, you can see how small text it can display, or big, scrolling, and things like that. Now, let's see the power consumption of this little device. I have plugged in my USB OLED display, and you can see that it now draws around 0.06 amps. It's not a big deal, but let's unplug the screen to see how that changes. Okay, let's see, it's 0.6, and now I'm unplugging the screen. Okay, the difference is small, it is around 10 milliamps. If I plug the screen back in, yes, it's around 10 milliamps. The precision of this device is not very big, but you can see that this OLED screen needs very little power. So, that is the review and driving of the OLED display. If you like the video, press like below and subscribe to our channel, because we are going to use this OLED screen in many projects to come. Thank you very much.